Hi and welcome. I'm Kaosarah, Abdulfatai. Welcome to my channel, Personal Development with Video. So in this video, I'm going to be teaching you two ways on which you can grow as a new YouTuber, and that is how to beat the YouTube algorithm and also understanding the YouTube algorithm. So video is divided into two, and this is the second part. So make sure you watch the previous part on how to understand the YouTube algorithm, so you come back to this so you'll be able to understand better on the explanation of things you should know using your mobile device. Okay guys, before I begin, let me give a shout out to this number one fan who do watch my videos. So if you love any of my content, always tell me in the comment section and give question in the comment section, then you'll be next to be given a shout out. So guys, thank you for always commenting on my channel. I appreciate and I love your interaction in the comment section. So now let's begin the video proper. So we will be using these two apps, which is the Chrome and also the YouTube Studio. So the Chrome is just to help us check our YouTube channel analysis, like we are using the system, while the YouTube Studio will also help you check your analytics on your phone. But to get a better view, you can use your Chrome to get and understand everything proper. So I'll be showing you the difference and how the both of them work. So this is just to help us make things easier for we that use our phone to do YouTube and grow better on YouTube. So let's begin using our YouTube Studio. Now let's talk about the front page of how it looks like. This is how it looks like. We have the comments, videos, and the analytics of each video and everything your video normally talk about. So clicking on the analytics, we have the overview, cover, discovery, audience, interactive content, and lots more. So before you can say you want to beat the YouTube algorithm, then you must understand different things about the YouTube itself and what the algorithm wants. The algorithm actually wants the longest audience retention and how people are watching your video, how long they are staying on their platform, and how they are interacting with your video. So that's basically what the algorithm wants. Now understanding all this area of the YouTube Studio will make you understand, okay, this is what my video, this is what my audience want, let me try and do better in this area. So that's why I will be on explaining everything about the YouTube Studio itself. So the real-time view of currently I was having 56 as at when I record this video, and the real-time view were coming from this my evergreen videos. Like those videos bring views to my channel every single time. That's why you can see my channel is having the green. Now we have the watch time. So as at different dates, this different time, this is how my YouTube time were moving, growing, coming up and coming down. Each day it just keep going and coming. So as at this period when I was recording, this was the number of subscribers I have within this month that we are currently seeing, and we have watch time from subscribers. Guys, most of those that are watching my content and subscribing, please guys, support this channel by subscribing. I really need this. Thank you. So the likes and dislikes from my channel, the previous and the last 20 days, that's a comparison, and the top videos that are actually doing well. This is the top video that I'm actually doing well on my channel. So if you check your analytics using the YouTube Studio, you understand various areas of this analytics. Now the best way or the interesting part of the analytics is this discovery, how people are getting to see your channel. Now let's start with impression. Impression means number of times when YouTube have sent out your videos to different people and different areas and how they watch. Now the impression click through rate, that is how those people have seen your video and definitely click on it. As you can see, you can make the graph a little bit stretchy and you see how your channel have been growing through the impression click through rate. That is how people are seeing your thumbnail and are clicking on it. Sometimes it goes up, sometimes it comes down, but it has never gone below 3%, as you can see, and the highest I've had so far is still 5 to 6%. So if your impression is high, YouTube said the normal minimum is 2%. So if you're having more than 2%, then you are good to go. Be sure that the algorithm will definitely boost your content soon. Okay, so now the next one is the traffic source. So in the YouTube app, most of the things you have to understand is that the YouTube traffic source work in different areas. So we have the YouTube search. Tell me in the comment section if you want to know more about the different source and how they work. So now we have the top external source, which is the Google. I have a video about Google, so you can check that on how to rank on Google and how to rank on other top external source. But now let's talk about the YouTube search, like that is the videos that are ranking inside from my channel on YouTube. So these are the various videos and the percentage. The eloquence is the highest percentage, 4%, S recorder and lots more. So basically, as I said earlier, you must have this kind of content to be able to grow faster on YouTube. So check your analytics to understand how to manipulate and beat the YouTube algorithm. Top videos suggesting my content. So these are the various videos that are suggesting some of my other content. So now let's talk about the top playlist. This one is varied, so I don't really take my time on that. And now we have the audience, where we have the gender, we have the age. For this, my channel, I think female is more, and age wise I think 18 to 24. And top geographic, I'm having Nigeria, United States, Philippines. Thank you all for always watching my content, and for the rest people, please endeavor to always subscribe. Thank you. So we have all top subtitles, and we have teaser per click. That is, some people just watch the teaser of my video and then they are like, okay, let me watch this video to understand better. Why clicks per card shown? So some of my cards, that is my video, were being shown, and those now, this, some people clicked on it to actually watch. That's what it means by click by card shown. So the last one, which is the playlist, that is how people view my playlist to watch any of my content, and the videos view and the average time viewed while on my playlist. That's why it's good to create playlists. So mostly how or what make me spend more of my time is under discovery. So now let's check out the Chrome extension. Before we move down there, I would like to say it's good to have a system as a new YouTuber. It helps you understand the YouTube analytics proper and better. So if you have an opportunity, use that to check your YouTube analytics. And when you are doing that, you don't need to download anything, you just use the YouTube app. So that is why I will be using the YouTube Chrome on my phone to teach you how to check it on your mobile, on your system, whenever you want to check your analytics on your system. So guys, let's begin. First thing first, when you open your YouTube studio on your Chrome, like you open it, set it to desktop view or desktop extension on your mobile device, so you'll be able to see it as if you are checking it on your system. So now you go to views. Now on the opening page of the view, you see this overview, just like the way we saw it on the YouTube studio app. Now that's how it will show you here. But in this type, in this area, it only helps you to see clearer and brighter, and you can zoom and check everything properly, different from the way we're seeing it on your mobile device. So you can see how some of those things that were separated on the YouTube studio is now being joined together in the YouTube app. So you can basically see each area you want to see and even see more or further. So this is the YouTube studio looks like using your mobile device on your Chrome extension, and this is how it looks like using viewing it on your system. Using your system, you get to see it more clearer than the way you can see it on your phone using the same extension of this app. So now we have the key moment for audience retention. This is what I love to see more, how people actually watch some of my video. I have a video about this area, key moment for audience retention, so go check it out guys. Talk about the intro, continuous segments, spike and dips of how people have watched each of your video content. So as a new YouTuber, you need to understand what you should add in your video and what you should not add in your video that will make people watch your video from beginning to the end, and what information you need to pass across. So currently this is one of my video, and this is how the video is being watched and viewed in that area. Now I have the top videos, just like the way I've shown you everything in the YouTube studio on the mobile app. I'm just showing you this so you can understand better of how it normally look like on system and how it shows you more brighter and more wider. Like you can see more areas, like in this segment each segment you can just click on see more to see more. Now let's talk about the overview. Mainly what I usually tell or advise people to always check in their analytics is the reach tab. That is how people are finding your content, how people are viewing your content, in what area, the timing, everything they are using to see your content. That's the area I love people to always focus on. So if you focus on that area, it helps you grow more and faster. Now currently my impression on YouTube, having YouTube sent some of my videos for people like about 8,000 plus, and just 600 and something have watched my videos so far. So you can see if I can utilize this information I've gotten, then I'll have to check what's making people not watch the video to the last end, and things I should improve better and further. So that is why I love that reach tab. It helps you understand the analytics properly. Now this other area, which is also the subscriber area, that shows you the number of current subscriber you have, the number of current subscriber you have for the month, and the number of view per video subscription, and lots more. So understanding this help you better. I hope this help you. Tell me in the comment section. Don't forget to watch, like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for always watching. My name is Kaosarah Abdulfatai, and I would love to see you in my next video. So stay blessed and stay safe. See you guys till then. Okay, now bye.